Welcome to ISO 9001 2015 Quality Management Systems, Part 3 Quality Management System Principles. In Series 1, we have discussed earlier Part 1 on the revisions to ISO 9001 2008, what have been done in ISO 9001 2015. Part 2, brief interpretation of ISO 9001 2015 requirements. Now, in the Part 3, we are discussing the principles of quality management system. There are 7 quality management principles in ISO 9001:2015. They include customer focus, which is the primary activity of any organization. Without a customer, no organization can survive. So, the organization must focus on the customer, his requirements, and meet the requirements with the aim of enhancing customer satisfaction. And the leadership and the top management is very, very important. Leadership has to provide the strategic direction to the organization. They must bring out the vision, mission, the various objectives, policies of the organization, so that people can collate and empower to achieve the objectives what have been set by the organization. Coming to the third principle, engagement of people. You need to empower the people to get the best from them. So, you must build the competence levels of the people, make very, very clear the roles, responsibilities, authorities of the people, give them the challenging goals so that they will not get bored and they will try to achieve the challenging goals for the benefit of our organization, for the benefit of the people. Coming to the fourth principle, process approach. All the activities in the organization need to be carried out through a process. A process takes inputs, it has to generate outputs. So, a process must utilize all the resources that are available in terms of human resource, in terms of equipment, in terms of measuring tools, in terms of various other resources that are required. And then, the people must exercise control on the process so that they will be able to achieve the outputs which meet the objectives of the organization. Improvement. The improvement principle is that it should be a permanent philosophy of any organization. Without any improvement, the organization cannot survive. If you don't improve, your competitors will improve and overtake you. So, for that, you must use a principle of PDCA and you must identify the areas through evidence-based decision making. Naturally, the next principle is evidence-based decision making, where you collect the data, information, analyze the data and see that the areas which are feasible for improvement are identified and plan accordingly the improvement plan and rotate PDCA and improve the situation. And most important, we have a lot of interested parties. A customer is an interested party and the shareholders are an interested party, vendors are an interested party, employees are an interested party. Unless you manage relations with this, it is very difficult for you to survive. So, relationship management is the other principle. Like there are 7 management principles detailed in ISO 9001:2015. Let us discuss in detail one by one. The first principle is basically customer focus. The primary focus of quality management system is to meet customer requirements and to strive to exceed customer expectations. When you want that, you must determine what customer requirements are there. Not only now, what are going to be in future. And make your products, develop your products to meet those requirements. Sustained success is possible only when organization attracts and retains the confidence of customers. Through the customer focus, you will achieve customer satisfaction, which will basically provide you enhanced customer order book position, which will help you in improving the productivity and various other factors. Let us see what the results of a customer-focused organization can be. Let us see the business results of a customer-focused organization. Of course, a few parameters are given here. Let us see, if you see over a period of 5 years, the organization which focused on the customer, which have understood the requirements of the customer, which has met the requirements of the customer, which has exceeded the customer requirements, they improved the turnover, they improved the productivity, they enhanced the customer satisfaction. Because of enhancement of customer satisfaction, lot of orders they received. order they received from the referrals, order they received from the same customer for his own requirements. And they are able to improve the quality levels by getting a feedback from the customer, and their profits have skyrocketed and the organization is able to survive. For all this, we need a strong leadership. Leaders at all levels must establish unity of purpose. The top management or the top leader must establish what are the vision of the organization. What are the vision of the organization? What value the people need to follow? What are all the various objectives that need to be achieved at the organization level? What are all the various objectives that need to be achieved at the department level? What are all the various objectives that need to be achieved at the lower level? And there must be, the organization objectives must be cascaded down to the task level, and those things need to be monitored so that the organization will achieve the organizational objectives and improve their success over a period of time. Most important assets of any organization are the people. You must be able to tap the potential of the people. There is some change in the principle from with respect to ISO 9001 2008. The principle earlier is called as involvement of people. It has been changed to engagement of people, because involvement means only taking part. Most important is people must contribute to the stated objective. To clearly mean that, it has been changed to engagement of people. You must train, retrain the people, improve the competence levels, empower them, and give them the challenging goals. Give them the freedom for them to work. Let them work in the teams and improve the organization performance for the organization as well as for themselves. And you create a value in the organization for the customers. The other principle, so basically, through the people, you must be able to manage efficiently and effectively. All the activities in the organization are carried out through a process. Process is nothing but it takes the inputs in terms of raw materials, in terms of instructions, in terms of power, in terms of gas, various other resources, and it needs to convert into a finished product. While converting the finished product, they have to utilize the resources available in terms of human resource, in terms of equipment, in terms of the monitoring and measuring tools. The quality management system is composed of several interrelated processes. The focus is given here on the process approach in the various clauses. The main clause 4.4 talks on determination of the process, sequence of the process, and determining what that need to be achieved, what is the criteria. Everything has been clearly established in ISO 9001:2015. This principle is basically helps you to improve the performance of a process. In order to see that the process achieves the results, you must monitor and measure the process. What you need to do, you must make sure the inputs are right, what you have taken. The transformation activities consistently work, and the desired results you are able to achieve. When once you are able to achieve the results consistently over a period of time, try to improve this. Let us see a few examples of inputs. This is a very, very simplified diagram which covers the inputs, all the things including the resources, the outputs, what you need to achieve. The right resources, assign the job to a competent person, that is a qualified fellow. Right facilities, equipment, suitable work environment, correct materials, use the proven methods, validated methods. So, transform these inputs into the outputs. Outputs will automatically achieve you quality products, quality services, customer satisfaction, on-time delivery, or various other things. Now, you need to manage the process efficiently and effectively. There's a difference between efficiency and effectiveness. The effectiveness is to what extent the desired results are achieved. Efficiency, there should not be any waste in the inputs what you have taken. You must focus on zero waste. This is basically a process approach through which you will be able to improve the performance of each and every process. Coming to the other principle, improvement. As I told you earlier, improvement should be a permanent philosophy of any organization. Everywhere the improvement is possible. Improvement means an activity to enhance performance. The activity can be recurring, like a continual improvement, or a singular and dramatic improvement. Continual improvement means recurring activity to enhance performance, that is through incremental improvements. Incremental improvements can happen through quality circles, Kaizen teams. Whereas dramatic improvements will happen through cross-functional teams, total quality management teams. Successful organizations have an ongoing focus on improvement. Improvement is essential for any organization to maintain current level of performance, to raise the level of performance internally and externally, so that you create yourself opportunities and back the opportunities and improve the organizational performance. So for this, the best tool that need to be used is PDCA. This is also known as a Deming wheel. You must plan the improvement area. You must decide what objectives you need to achieve, what resources are required, what tools you need to use, which team you assign this. And according to this plan, start doing the plan, implement the plan. During the process of planning, you monitor, what you call check, whether you are able to realize the plan or are there any deviations. If there are, you find any deviations, you act on that. If you are able to achieve consistently, you act for further improvement and reset your plan so that you will be able to dramatically improve the performance of the organization. Evidence you see, for identifying the area for an improvement, you must just go on by an opinion basis. You must collect the facts, you must collect data, you must collect information, analyze that information, identify which area is more feasible, where the value addition is high. Such things, through the principle of an evidence-based decision-making process, you get those things, choose that particular area and rotate PDCA and improve the situation. Coming to the other principle, most important, let us say, you have a shareholder. You never bother to pay him a dividend. Do you think you will continue? No. You have a good vendors, but never you paid them in time. You have the employees, potential, and they have the competence, but you have utilized them, but never paid in time. So you must maintain a good relations with all the interested parties, so that they will basically help you. They will feel that they are a part of the organization and help to improve the performance of the organization, so that they will improve and your organization will improve. So these are all the 7 management principles which are included in ISO 9001:2015. For further details, contact myself, Samsara Thoda, and IRC UK registered lead auditor for QMS Forshaws, NQ UK approved witness auditor for QMS, CMS, Forshaws, ENMS, and also NQ approved lead tutor. My phone number is 98480-21382, and email ID is clearly given here, and you can